On July 2nd, First Assembly's mission team began our journey. We traveled to Ecuador, and we were going to a land that is high up in the Andes. We were in an area where there were actually no trees above a certain height. We were also in an area where we would be looking down upon the clouds. In this height, sometimes when we were working on our work project, we would actually be short of breath due to the oxygen deprivation. The city of Cuenca itself is at an elevation of 8,500 feet. Our host for this trip was Bill McDonald. He's been an Assembly of God missionary in Ecuador since 1989. Due to his work, between 50 and 100 churches have been planted and begun. He now runs Uncion Television, which broadcasts Spanish language broadcasting to all of North and South America. And he also still pastors a church, which meets in the Uncion church building. So he's still a very active and busy man and pastor. Our liaison was a couple named Robert and Amber Oliver, a husband and wife team that just started working down there this past year. We found them to be very genial, and Robert we admired because he attended our morning devotionals every morning of the trip. Spanish reestablished Cuenca as their own city. They built at the four corners of the city a monument that included a cross. It was a symbol of their Catholic faith. At the corner of one of these places is an old trade school that was operated by the city for many years. But about a year and a half ago, they could not run anymore, and recently they turned it over in a 30-year lease to Uncion, who wants to use it now to teach trades and to teach people about Jesus. It's in a neighborhood that's somewhat run down, and right next door is a Satan-worshipping church. We worked in a garden area that was in the center of the building that they are hoping to use for the Royal Rangers children to be in during the day. There is a front room area where the counseling center will be, and people call into this counseling center in response to their Uncion broadcasting. Right now, they are averaging 24 people getting saved by telephone every single day. In the garden area, we cut tree branches, we pulled vines, we cut the grass. After pulling the vines, we dug up rocks. The farther down that we dug, the bigger the rocks got. In fact, they were about 2 to 3 feet long and probably weighed hundreds of pounds each. They were very, very heavy. We also hauled away trash and litter and vines and compost materials and dirt and stones and rocks, carrying them to closets and to a trash pile. And in the front room, we also painted. We worked on painting the walls. We worked on painting the woodwork. We did not finish that job. That job would be continued by the mission teams that would come after us. We filled two closets full of the medium-sized and smaller-sized rocks. We also filled a very large area full of the trash that we hauled away. Underneath all of that grass, we discovered a whole new walkway we did not know was there. We lined it with large rocks for benches. We also tried to level the dirt area in the whole area and cleaned it up. And here we have a site of the open area where they will plant grass, and hopefully it'll be an area for the Royal Rangers children to play in. Here are some scenes of the people that we saw in Ecuador. We did not get to deal with them a whole lot. They did have shoeshine stands there. Here are some ladies who were actually working in a leather goods store where we did shop. And here is a man who is wearing the traditional Ecuadorian dress. And here are some of the Royal Rangers' children. Cuenca is the third largest city in Ecuador with over 500,000 people. Alcoholism is a big problem. One out of four people is alcoholic. The city's name means nectar of the gods. The downtown area where we were, the streets were quite narrow and they were all one way. There is a city park. The city parks are often places where people go at night to sleep off after drinking heavily. The Catholic Church is a big institution in Ecuador. Evangelicals have to minister carefully. It's seen as competing religion. Robert Oliver told us that when asked about his views on the Virgin Mary, he said he believes what is in their Bible. We socialize every morning in devotionals, but in the evenings we socialize together at mealtime. We traveled together almost everywhere that we went. We got to try many new and exotic foods. Missionaries are often expected to try new exotic foods. And here we have Darby rejoicing that Pastor Jeff is offered the first bite of roast guinea pig. Here we are being introduced to the youth service on Saturday night. For all the members of our team whose first time this was, worshiping in a service in a foreign language, they realized that the Holy Spirit of God was moving there also. And here we have Pastor Jeff Call delivering a message on responding in faith to God's call, translated in Spanish. The youth pastor asked Pastor Jeff to come up and lead prayers for the people. And here we have a scene where the pastors are laying hands on and praying for people. Mark Mitchell ministered at the Unción's Alcoholics and Substance Abuse Meeting.
Shall prosper, que no prosperará. And I pray against the enemy of alcohol.
Y oro, Señor, que el enemigo que se llama alcohol.
And I loose this man in the name and the power of Jesus.
Y lo libero a este hombre en el nombre y en el poder de Jesucristo.
God, your word says.
Señor, tu palabra dice.
Whom the Son sets free.
Cuando el Hijo del Hombre te libertare.
Is free in me.
Estás verdaderamente libre.
Devil, you are a liar.
Diablo, tú estás fuera.
And you're the father of lies.
Y tú eres el padre de mentiras.
I speak the truth of the Lord Jesus.
And we now want you to just see some of the candid pictures of our team during the trip. Mission team members want to thank you, the church, for your financial support and for your prayer support.